So my name is Stephen Chase, and I'm an assistant professor jointly appointed in the Department of Biomedical Engineering and the Center for the Neural Basis of Cognition. And I design brain-computer interfaces, and I use these devices to study motor learning and motor control. We don't understand how your brain controls your limb. If we did, we could essentially make an arm that looked as much like a limb as possible. We could just recreate that mapping and you'd be off and running. But we don't understand that because limb control is very, very complicated. So because we can't make something exact, you have to learn how to use this artificial system that isn't reacting much like what natural motor control would do. And the idea is that if we can understand this learning process better, we can make devices that will work when we plug them in, that we can get out to patients in the real world and help them regain motor function. So a brain-computer interface takes signals, recorded signals from the brain, and the ones I use are directly from neurons in primary motor cortex, which is the part of the brain that controls movement. And we use them to directly control some device, like a cursor on a computer screen or a robotic arm. And the idea is that somebody who's lost the ability to move, somebody who's paralyzed, but still has all of that motor control ability locked into their head, we can take these devices, we can tap out the intention to move, and then we can move a device for them. So I've created this, in some senses, arbitrary mapping between neural activity and cursor movement, and the brain is very good at figuring out how to refine that process and how to make the cursor do what you want it to do. Carnegie Mellon really encourages collaboration, and the kinds of things I do unites techniques from statistics, machine learning, neurobiology, engineering, and so no one person could really be an expert in all of those various fields, but we work together. So I work with people in statistics, I work with people in machine learning, and together we approach these questions about the brain from all these different perspectives, and Carnegie Mellon really encourages that.